All right, here we go. Good. Look good. Check my hair. Go. Got any boogers? No. All right. Hey y'all, what's going on? This is Day once again from let's do that again. Hey y'all, what's going on? Happy New Year. Happy, got some hair right there. Ah, got you. Happy 2020, a year of vision, a year of seeing fruit, a year of difference, and I want to say goodbye to 2019. Hello, 2020. I'm excited about the things to come, and welcome to our first installment of Natural Light for the year 2020. Woo! Sound effects right here. Hey! Anyway, after Christmas break, seeing people open up presents, mainly my son, and just watching him open up gifts and play with his gifts and continue to want to share his gifts, mainly with me, and playing with toys, it reminded me of the importance and the wonderful blessing that us as people and God's people get to use the gifts that he gave us. And this video will definitely, hopefully, prayerfully speak to some of you creative people, speak to some of you people with vision and mission and plans that have been procrastinating. If you have been, I hope that this video motivates you. And speaking straight from scripture, which is 1 Peter 4 and 10, I believe, where paraphrasing, God talks about how we are to use our gifts to help and glorify God first and help people. Just watching, like I said, Christmas, and then my son play with his toys and open up his toys and share it with his friends and with his family. I just look at people with gifts, and when they're using it right and they're using it in excellence, how much it blesses me. Like LeBron James has a gift, right? If LeBron James is procrastinating on his gift, it's not the same. So watching LeBron James and his gift, it blows my mind, right? And I'm sure it blows God's mind. Watching singers, one of my favorite rappers, Kendrick Lamar, watching him go on stage and use the gift and the calling that God calls him and being excellent with it, always blesses me. Even like chefs, I watch a lot of HGTV, chefs and carpenters and just people with this amazing God-given talent that only they have, and watching them steward their gifts and watching them excel and accelerate and just be excellent in their gifts. There's something amazing about watching that, and it really is a breath of fresh air. And more importantly than being amazed, I'm blessed by it. So like I said, from 1 Peter 4 and 10, I just want you guys to understand why God gave you your gift and why procrastinating and not using it in the proper means is dangerous. One of my favorite sayings is, it's great to be a dreamer, but don't live in a bed. And I'm preaching to myself, hopefully to you as well. But if there's something that you are gifted and talented at doing, do not let the lies of the enemy and the lies within your mind trick you to think that it's not important and that it's not valuable. I watch a lot of Shark Tank, and the craziest, funniest thing to me is when some of the investors, they say, well, this idea is not proprietary. People have done it before. It's easy to get ripped off. Maybe, but nobody can do it like you. And nobody can bring what you bring to the table. And that's a lie. That's the lies that the enemy sometimes tell you. Oh, this has been done before. This is not valuable. This is not important. Shut it up, Lululu. And listen to what God tells you. If God is calling you to bigger and greater things, and he's already giving you the skill, the talent, and the ability to do it, just jump in, run, turning my car off. Jump in, run, and do what you need to do in order to bless other people like me, people throughout the world that will benefit and will learn and will be inspired by your gift. So whether you are a weightlifter, a trainer, shout out to my cousin BJ, man, he's amazing at motivating other people. People like him, people like LeBron James, people like the simple people right down the street, teachers, educators, counselors, chefs, carpenters, pastors, rappers, singers. There's so many gifts and there's so many arts. We're naturally made in the image of God, and he's a creative, powerful, wise God, and I want you to be the same. So I'm going to zoom in a little bit. You, be motivated today. Be urgent today. Be zealful in your gift. Do not hold on to it, because there's the best and the most amazing talented people. Guess where they are? In the grave, because they never, ever, 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 ever got to see their gift come to fruition. So I hope this challenges you. I hope you're inspired, and I can't wait. And there's a nation, there's a world of people that need you to stop procrastinating, so they too can be blessed by your gift. Go read the Bible for yourself. I'm not making this stuff up. 1 Peter 4:10. Day one, natural light. Holla at me. Peace. And I'm digging this new camera. Holla!